Hi, Mark Savage here. We got a real special car to look at here today. Somebody thought it was going to be a cold day in, well, Wisconsin before you get to drive one of the new Corvette Stingrays. Well, it's that day. It's November. It's chilly in Wisconsin, but we got a nice sunny day. This is the Corvette Stingray Z51, and it is an absolute beautiful car and an absolute rocket when you get it out on the freeway. Okay, so the Corvette, first of all, you know, you look at this thing, it looks like a Corvette. It's still got the long pointy nose and so forth. The rollaway headlights went away several years ago in the last generation. And if you look at the car, it's got big rounded front fenders, kind of exciting looking, very sleek. And then they've put a number of different air scoops and so forth on the car so that it helps bring the air from under the hood out, so you relieve some of the pressure under the hood, so it cuts the lift that you'd normally get on the car if you're going at a high rate of speed. In the back then, there's some other air scoops that let the air to come in, and then it goes through and cools your transmission and your differential, and then that exits out some vents in the back right by the taillights. One of the things people have talked about with the new Corvette is that it has a much nicer, a richer looking interior than the old Corvette, which had some plastic parts in it. Didn't look quite that great. It wasn't bad, but it didn't look as nice as you'd expect a $50,000 to $70,000 car. So this one has the leather dash, has the red stitching in it, nicely finished, really looks sharp. And it's got the digital video screen that is your all your controls here. And gauges. So what you can see is right now I've got on the sports setting. You can adjust five different settings for the car, and it goes, there's touring, there's eco, which I'm sure everybody who drives a Corvette's going to want that eco mode on, weather, which I assume gives you a little bit better traction when the weather gets wet, which we would have certainly here in Wisconsin. Then you go to the track setting, and you'll see that it adjusts the dash, so now you've just got your mile an hour right in the center. The tack is basically up to your red line, and then it tells you your best speed, your previous speed, your current, you know, that lap times that you're doing. So if you're going to take this out on the track, it's already set for you. You don't have to do anything. The other interesting thing you'll notice on the inside here is on the gear shift, we got seven speeds. So we got seven speeds plus reverse. Obviously, the top sixth and seventh are to help save you gas when you're out on the freeway and just rolling along. This is rated at 29 miles per gallon on the highway. So, you know, muscle car, yes, fast, yes, but if you're going to go out and cruise and take a nice drive, it's going to get decent gas mileage. 2014 Corvette Stingray. Beautiful car. I mean, the styling, I think that they've absolutely nailed it this time. You know, is it the world's greatest car? I don't know, but it's going to be way up there in the top two or three at a reasonable price for a muscular, almost supercar that'll go 190 mile an hour, 460 horsepower. There's a lot of numbers you can say about a Corvette. Most of them add up to one. I want one. That's Mark Savage, Savage on Wheels. Keep looking at our website.